So before we actually start digging into authentication, we're going to need to know how forms work. So let's start by creating a signup form, and then we'll take it from there. So first, we're going to need a controller. So let's do node ace make controller. As your application gets older and becomes more mature, the authentication flow can get rather complex. So we're going to create one controller per action bound to authentication. So we're going to do a register controller, login controller, and a logout controller for that complete flow. For right now, though, we'll just start with our register controller. And let's put all of these controllers specifically for authentication inside of a folder called auth. So if we just do auth slash and then the controller name, the make controller command will create a folder called auth and then the actual controller file for whatever we provide on the right hand side of the slash. So we could do register. We want to keep register singular. So we do hyphen s there to tell the make controller command that we intend for register to be singular. Okay, so let's run that. Cool. So now we have our new register controller inside of our auth folder, inside of our controllers and app directory. So let's dive into that. Let's do auth register controller. And there it is. Let's get our HTTP context uncommented. We'll do async and let's do show because this will be in charge of showing the register form. View HTTP context, return view render pages. We'll put this inside of an auth folder, just the same as our controllers. And we'll call the file register. All right, let's go create that view real quick. So views, pages. Right click that, new file, create a folder called auth, and then inside of the auth folder, create a file called register.edge. We'll have our layout, go ahead and end that as well. Let's go ahead and take our movie card and just kind of generalize it. So let's copy everything that we have inside of here, right click our components, new file, and we'll create a file called card.edge there. Paste those contents in, and now we just want to get rid of everything content based. We'll keep the padding for div, and then for the picture here, we can make that optional. So let's do at if slots.picture at end if. Go ahead and cut that out. Await slots.picture and render that out as an optional slot. And then for the actual contents, we'll do await slots.main so that we can put whatever we want inside of the card. Okay, give that a save. We should be able to jump into our movie card component now and get rid of a good portion of the boilerplate here. So we can go ahead and get rid of the class. And instead of our div, we can do at card. We're going to want to spread in our props, except for the movie, and we'll just let that cascade through. We can get rid of our div there. Then we'll want to do at slot picture around our actual picture and end that slot. Okay. And then we can get rid of the padding for, and everything else just becomes our card content. Get rid of these two divs and our card component. And lastly, fix our indenting. There we go. Give that a save. Let's make sure that worked okay. npm run dev, jump into our browser, and cool. Our cards still all look the exact same, so we're a-okay there. Jump back into our text editor and let's go back to our register page. Okay, so let's apply that card. We'll add a class to it and we'll just do max width, probably MD, I think, just so that it doesn't attempt to take up the entire page and end that card. All right. So we're gonna need a form and let's go take a look at our user model here and remind ourselves what all we're dealing with. So we have a full name, avatar URL we won't worry about during registration, email and password. Okay, jump back into our register page. So we'll do a label, class flex, flex call, and we'll do a span, class text, extra small, font bold, and call that full name. And then we'll want to do an input where the type is text and the name is the same as the model's column name. So that would be full name there. The reason why we specifically want to name it that is because whenever we submit our form, this is the name we'll be able to access it by on our server side. And naming it the same name that we have inside of our column just simplifies actually creating our user record. Okay, let's give that a copy and a paste two times because we're also going to need our email and a password. So the type here will be email and the name as we have it defined on our column is email. So we'll have that as email there as well. And then this one is password with a type password. All right, then we need a submission button so that we can actually submit our form. So at button type submit at end. And we'll just put the text as register. Let's also give our labels a little bit of spacing in between one another. So we'll do class, flex, flex call, gap of 4. Then in order to actually see this page, we need to register it up to a route. So let's do command P to open up our file search and type in routes and hit enter there to jump into our routes file. Okay, and then down here, let's do router dot, and let's define a route group. We'll provide a callback function into this. And any routes that we define inside of this actual group's callback method will get applied anything that we specify specifically for the group. So for example, we can prefix our group with slash auth. And now any routes that we define inside of this callback will actually start with slash auth. Do the same thing with a name as well. So we could do as auth there. Okay. So let's do router.get slash register. We'll have our register controller, hit tab to auto import that. And we have our show method. We'll name this as register show. All right. So if we scroll down a little bit here, hit save so that that formats. What we've just done is defined a route at slash auth slash register. And the name is now auth.register.show. Thanks to this group, we'll be able to apply these to all of the routes, simplifying the internal definition for all of our authentication paths. So with that defined, we should be able to jump into our browser, head into the URL bar, and go to auth slash register, hit enter, and there we go. We see our card. Our inputs are there. They just don't have any styling, but they are there. And then we have our register button. Let's get our inputs where we can see them and sure up a little bit of that styling. So let's jump back into our register edge page. On our form, we'll do a margin top of 4. Outside of our card, we'll do a div class flex justify center so that it's centered within the page. Go ahead and collapse our form down and end our div after our card ends and give everything there an indent. Lastly, on our inputs, I think maybe we just do this inside of the actual CSS file. So we'll jump inside of our app.css. Input not type equals radio and not type equals checkbox. So if we have an input that's not a radio or a checkbox, we'll go ahead and just apply order slate 300 rounded px 3 py 1.5. And then if it's focused, we'll do border. Oh, we haven't picked a brand color yet. Let's do, I guess, indigo, maybe 500. And we'll add a small duration 300 so that it fades from our slate to our indigo. Okay, give that a save. If we jump back into our browser now, all right, that's a little bit better. At least we can see our inputs now. I put the margin top on our form instead of the card, so that's why the card's still flush up against the border there. So we'll move that margin top up to our card. There we go. Okay. So now we need an actual handler for this form whenever we click on register. Right now, it's just going to submit us back to slash auth register with the fields applied as a query string, since we haven't specified anything specifically for the form to do. So let's jump back into here. We're going to need an action for our form, and we'll also want to specify the method as post. Okay. Let's jump back into our routes. And let's define another route. So we'll do router.post this time because we want to handle the post submission for our form slash register, register controller, and we'll call this store as register store. Give that a save. Now we want to jump into our register controller, async store. We're going to want our request and response so that we can handle the request and send an applicable response, HTTP context. So when we submit our form, we're going to want to create a user with the details that are provided. And then once we create the user, we're going to want to log them in. And then once we log them in, we want to send them off back to our application. So at the end of the day, our end task is to send them back to the homepage. So we'll start with the ending task. So let's return response, and we'll want to redirect them to the route we've named home. Then we need to grab the fields that we need off of the request. There's actually a few different ways that we can do it. So we could do const data equals request dot all. And as they're telling us here within the hint, this will return a reference to all of request data within the body and the query string. So whenever we call this, we can console.log out our data to see exactly what we've received. Let's give that a save, jump back into our register page. And now the action for our form, we want to send out to our new route of auth.register.store. All right, so let's give that a save. Let's jump back into our browser and give it a run. So full name here, we'll put John Doe, test at test.com, and something for the password. We'll hit enter to submit that. And we got returned right back to where we were because we forgot about CSRF. So let's jump back into our text editor. And on our form, we want to apply the CSRF field so that we get a hidden input with a CSRF token that will actually allow for our registration form to submit. Okay, with that in place, let's jump back into our browser. John Doe once more, test at test.com, and password. Hit enter there. Okay, now we are back at the home page. So if we jump back into our terminal, we're going to see that we got back for our data an object with that CSRF token that allowed us to submit our form, our full name, email address, and the supplied password. Well, we don't care about that CSRF token, so all may not be applicable to us. Within our text editor, if we jump back to our register controller, we could extract out just the fields that we care about. So full name, email, and password like so. Or if we go back, we could use request.only to specify the fields that we care about. And the field names that we supply within this array are the only fields that we'll get back inside of our data. So for this, we could supply full name, email, and our password. And with that in place, if we jump back into our browser, we need to add a link to this, but we'll do auth register there. Let's do John Doe again, test at test.com, and another password, hit enter there. Let's take another look at our terminal. And there we can see that now we only have our data of full name, email, and password. That CSRF token was omitted because we didn't specify it inside of the only array. Ideally though, we would be verifying that the user is actually submitting the fields that we require with the actual data that we require those fields to contain. So we would be verifying that they're supplying a full name, email, and password because those are all required to actually register within our application. And then we would also be verifying that the full name is a string, the email is a valid email address, and the password is probably at least 8 characters long or anything else that we want to require for our password fields. That's where validation comes into play, and AdonisJS uses their own homegrown validation library called VineJS to do so. We'll take a look at that in the next lesson, but before we move on, let's add a link to our register page so that we can easily get to it. So we'll want to jump down into our layout, or maybe our navigation actually. So we'll jump down to our partials, our nav, and let's class flex justify between items center. We'll wrap these three anchors in another div, paste them back in, and then we'll do another div so that we have a left and a right side of our navigation with an href pointing to our route, auth register show page, and we'll call that register. Give that a save, and now if we jump back into our browser, we have our home, directors, writers, as well as now a register page button. Cool. Let's add a quick register heading onto this as well. So we'll jump back into our text editor, over to our register.edge page. We'll put this above our form. Let's do a h1 register, just like so. And let's actually move that outside of the card. Okay, there we go. And let's see how that looks. Oh. Switch that to flex call. Switch that to item center. There we go. Okay, that's at least doable. Okay, let's go ahead and stop there.